Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be answering the question, do you need winter tires if it doesn't snow? And so I've got two different sets of tires for my Honda S2000. I've got some ultra high performance summer tires on it, which are on it right now. And then I've also got a set of winter tires, which I'm going to put on and test after testing these summer tires. So the whole idea is that summer tires have something called, and all tires will have something called a glass transition temperature. This is basically a property of rubber. So above this glass transition temperature, the rubber is soft and malleable and, you know, conforms to the road. Below this temperature, it gets very hard and plastic-like. And so a lot of tire manufacturers say this is generally around 40 to 45 degrees Fahrenheit for summer tires. And so it's well below freezing. It's below that temperature right now outside. There's no snow on the ground, so we're not, you know, obviously I think a winter tire is going to do better than a summer tire on the snow. What we're going to figure out is if it's below freezing outside, you know, are you going to benefit from a winter tire or are you going to be okay on a summer tire? So that's what we're going to figure out right here, just doing a simple braking test. I've got my equipment set up. I'll include links to all of this stuff so you know what I'm using in the video description. And so let's go ahead and go test these summer tires, see how they brake. Okay, so I'm going to be running the same test three times. I'm going to accelerate up to 65 miles per hour. Then at the same location, I'm going to slam the brakes. ABS is going to do all the work. It's going to be ABS braking. And we're going to measure the time from 60 miles per hour down to a dead stop. So from 60 to zero, that's the distance we're going to measure. And we're going to see what the difference is using summer versus winter tires. So first off is our first run with the summer tires. Definitely a little squirrely there. I've done this before when it was warm outside and it was not nearly as squirmy. The car's kind of shaking all over the place in the cold. And I am not that great at translating meters, but our results are in meters, so all the metric people are going to be excited. I'll include, of course, what this is in feet, but 38.7 meters was our 60 to 0 for the first test with the summer tires. Ooh. Okay, we will run one more test and see how we do. Ooh, that one was a little bit better. So our final test on summer tires, we're looking at a 60 to 0 in 38.7 meters and a 30 to 0 in 9.7 meters. So a little bit better than the second run, but about the same as the first run. So we're looking at about 127 to 130 feet of stopping distance, 60 to 0, when it's below freezing temperatures outside and you're on summer tires. So now we're going to go ahead and switch and we're going to put winter tires on. These are using the exact same AP1 wheels. It's a different set of wheels, but both sets of tires are going to be on stock AP1 wheels. So we're going to be comparing the difference between this winter compound and the summer compound. Okay, it is day two. I've got the winter tires on. Yesterday, I did a bunch of driving. Primarily, I did a bunch of hard stops just to make sure that the outer layer of those tires was worn in enough so that they were broken in so that they'd be good for testing. But I also wanted to drive them a bit in the snow and see how they felt. And I have to say, it's extremely impressive how well winter tires can do in the snow and the ice. I had a lot of fun driving this thing, and it's amazing. You know, when I have those summer tires on, any ice or snow, it's like the tires are basically plastic and they have zero grip and you just immediately start sliding. So it's really cool to have traction in the snow and it's weird to do it in something like an S2000. But that's not the point of this test. The point of this test is to figure out if it doesn't snow but it's really cold, can you do any better stopping wise with winter tires? And my hypothesis is that they won't actually do much better. The summer tires actually did okay, all things considered, in the dry with the stopping distance. You know, I think these may be close, but to me they feel like they're not going to stop quite as good. We will see with the testing. One thing for sure, you do lose steering response with winter tires. So, you know, that tread block is softer and you feel it kind of squirm around on the road. It's not nearly as, you know, quick to turn in like summer tires are, which are, you know, firmer. And as you turn the steering wheel, it's very quick to turn in with you. But that's just a note about how the steering feels. And now let's get into the testing about how they actually stop. Okay, here we go with test number one, winter tires. Wow. So results from the first test, 60 to 0 in 47.7 meters, 30 to 0 in 12 meters. So certainly a longer distance there for stopping. Interesting to see, and you know, kind of what I was thinking when I was testing them yesterday. I felt like the braking wasn't quite as strong, and it's not. So while they do perform well, certainly in the snow and ice, it seems they are certainly a drawback when it is dry. Even if it is cold, it's 26 degrees out right now. When I was testing the summer tires, it was 24 degrees, so very similar temperature-wise, but regardless, a longer stopping distance. Okay, test number two. Something worth noting, so far both of the tests with the winter tires, when I slam on the brakes, it stays perfectly straight and I really don't have to adjust it much. Versus the summer tires, especially the first time I did a hard brake, they were quite squirmy and you kind of had to fight it to keep it to go straight. That said, even still, the braking distance is significantly longer with these winter tires than with the summer tires in 25 degree Fahrenheit temperatures. Okay, final test. Slightly better than our last test, but not by much. 49.9 meters, 60 to 0, 12.26 for the 30 to 0. So fascinating to see what we've learned. If you live in an area where it gets cold but it doesn't snow, you could probably be fine with your all seasons or your summer tires left on the car. And then if there is a little bit of snow or ice one day, you know, don't take your car out. That said, you know, if you do live in an area where you do have plenty of ice and snow, you can certainly take advantage by getting winter tires. So this was fascinating to me. I was surprised how big of a difference there was between the summer and the winter tires in the cold. The summers definitely were degraded from how they do in the summer, but still did decent enough and significantly better than winter tires in these, you know, below freezing temperatures. So interesting to see. Now, one thing worth mentioning, I went with a recommended setup of a square setup, so 205s on both the front and the rear. That keeps the tire diameters very similar to what the rears were anyways. And so it's a square setup, so the rear tires were slightly narrower than the summer tires, 20 millimeters on each end. Now, I don't think that's near enough of a difference to see the difference that we saw in stopping distance. I don't think it's going to make that big of a deal as far as stopping distance. But one thing it may do, I mean, keep in mind, you know, the front is doing most of the work anyways, and the front tires were the exact same width in both scenarios. One thing it may do, however, is mess with the ABS system. So the ABS system is designed for a car with 225s in the back and 205s up front rather than 205s front and rear. And so it may slightly affect how the ABS system is able to interact with the tires and get maximum braking out of them. Just one thing worth mentioning, but aside from that, same wheels, same temperature outside, same exact braking location, starting from the same speed and measuring from 60 to 0. So really keeping everything consistent. Wind speeds were not an issue. I was monitoring that the whole time. Didn't have any wind out there. So that's why I choose this place out in the middle of nowhere. It's a great place for doing testing like that. So hopefully you guys have learned something. I've certainly found this fascinating. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.